Queensland is often where federal elections are won and lost, and 2019 is shaping as no different, with the Sunshine State home to a host of marginal seats. It's why Prime Minister Scott Morrison and opposition leader Bill Shorten have been blitzing the state. 11 electorates are held on margins of less than 4%. Labor will be looking to sandbag its 3 marginal seats and targeting as many as 8 in the coalition column. There could be some big scalps for Labor as well. Home Affairs Minister Peter Dutton has held his seat of Dixon for almost 2 decades, but with a margin of just 1.7%, he is facing an uphill battle to stay in Parliament. Further north in Dawson, controversial coalition character George Christensen is also fighting to keep his seat of Dawson after it was revealed he spent almost 300 days in the Philippines over 4 years. Bill Shorten and Labor has its own headaches. The opposition leader is walking a tightrope between pleasing progressive metropolitan suburbs and more conservative rural voters. That's brought into sharp focus by the divisive Adani mega coal mine planned for central Queensland. Many think it's vital for jobs and the economy, while others see an environmental disaster.
Stop Adani!
And then there's the Queensland wildcards. Pauline Hanson's One Nation, Bob Katter's Australian Party, and Clive Palmer's United Australia. The big vote for small parties shows disaffection in the Queensland electorate is high, and they could take a large bite out of the major party's vote. Where their preferences flow could be vital, and the coalition deal to secure the support of mercurial billionaire Clive Palmer will probably deal him back into Parliament.